Hi, I'm Rick Vanover from Veeam. The Veeam Agent for Linux is a very powerful way to protect physical systems as well as systems on different hypervisors that are running the Linux operating system. It might seem confusing or overwhelming on how to do it, but trust me, this is a very easy way to protect these critical systems. Let's take a look at a quick demo to see just how easy this is. The Veeam Agent for Linux is a very good way to do backups of Linux systems, and I recommend that everyone start in the Help Center. This part of the Veeam documentation has really good information about what platforms are supported, and if we look right here, these are the distributions that are supported with Veeam Agent for Linux. You can find the latest information at helpcenter.veeam.com. Now, once we have this, let's go over to the inventory section of Veeam Backup and Replication. If you saw my other videos on how to do Windows backups, this is really similar. We're going to add a new protection group for Linux systems. So let's go ahead and create a protection group. Let's give this protection group a name, and I recommend these names be very descriptive, self-describing. So this one we'll call Linux Agent Protection Group. Now, unlike the other one, I'm going to go with individual computers in this example. For the Windows ones, it made sense for Active Directory, but in this example, we're just going to add a list. Now, when we create that list, we're going to add the system by DNS name. Highly recommend doing that because IPs change. And once you do that, you'll also want to add an admin credential. This is a credential with the requirements documented at Help Center, so definitely check that out first. I'm going to add two systems here. Both of them are Ubuntu systems, and there's the broad selection of distributions, but I'm going to add two Ubuntu systems just here. Now, like other protection groups, by default, this protection group will install the agent, and you'll see this option for the Windows change block tracking driver. I don't recommend mixing them because it's not really necessary. And every day at 9 p.m., this protection group will rescan and add new systems if they are added to the list. So just like that, we have a protection group, and once we have this made, we can easily go ahead and create a backup job. So let's watch while the discovery runs. It should determine that both of those systems are eligible to have the Veeam Agent for Linux deployed, and let's watch this progress. One thing to think about, we have a bunch of different videos at Veeam.com. You can subscribe to our channel. Let us know if you want some more advanced use cases shown on these videos. I'm deploying a rather textbook example, but let us know if you want something. You'll see right here that the Veeam Agent for Linux has been installed, and it should finish up momentarily for both of these. There it is. Once the protection group is run, we can go ahead and create a backup job. So let's make a new one. Like the other examples, we can make them managed by the server or the workstation and have different types of backups. I'm going to go with the server type of job managed by the server. I'm going to give it, again, a very descriptive name of these systems I'm backing up. And you also want to make sure that you have the specific list of what you're backing up scoped to that protection group. You can add multiple protection groups, by the way. I only have the one here. You have additional options on backing up the entire computer or individual files or even drives. I like the entire computer approach because you know you won't miss anything. You can select individual backup repositories from the list of what is configured within Veeam Backup and Replication, which is part of Veeam Data Platform. I have some object storage. I'm going to go ahead and select that, but the full list of your existing repositories are available for selection in the wizard. If you've ever done a regular Veeam backup job, this should look really familiar. Now, I also could do individual application aware processing or file system indexing. At a minimum, I recommend using the file system indexing option, and it'll use the protection group credentials to get that done. I also like to set a schedule that runs soon after the protection group. I'm going to go with 10 p.m., which is 1 hour after the discovery. So if any new systems are added, they'll be backed up within an hour. So let's go ahead and run this job. So basically, I've created the protection group and a job, and these two Linux systems with the Veeam Agent for Linux are being backed up as we speak. So you'll see both of those will start and their backup jobs will be running from central managed perspective of the Veeam backup and replication server, pushing this out to the Veeam agents. This is a really easy way to protect these Linux systems. So just like that, it's really easy to protect Linux systems with the Veeam agent for Linux. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We've got a bunch of different videos that we're working on, but we also want to know what you want to see. So leave a comment below. Also, if you download a trial of Veeam Data Platform, you can have a fully functioning version, including the Veeam agent for Linux. Super easy to use. Go on over to veeam.com and download a trial today.